So since November, ACF have been carrying out an emergency nutrition program here in Tacloban. In the first instance, ACF were operating using mobile clinics. That was just after the emergency when all local infrastructures, or the majority of them, were no longer functioning. So in terms of malnutrition treatment, the first step is community outreach. So actually screening of children in the barangay, in the places where they live. Any children that are suspect of having malnutrition, they will be sent to the local health center where malnutrition will be confirmed. If the child is severely malnourished but without medical complications, treatment can happen in the health center using a product, a peanut butter type of product called Plum Peanut. Where there's a severely malnourished child with medical complications, they have to be sent to the local hospital where there's an inpatient treatment facility. Those children are treated at first with therapeutic milk, just until the child is stabilized and has an appetite. Then the child will be referred back to the health center to continue their treatment with Plum Peanut.
So with the help from ACF, we expect that we would be able to set up a mal ward so that we would be able to manage our severely malnourished patients. We have so many malnourished patients compared to other regions. Throughout the Philippines, we are in the top three.
So our plans for the future are to continue working now as we are, more going into developing local capacities rather than direct interventions ourselves. So we're going to continue working in local health centers, particularly with a focus on training local health staff to carry out the activities that ACF have been doing. So today, for example, we're here in the health center from San Jose, where ACF are supporting local health staff to carry out those same nutritional activities. So screening children, identifying children as malnourished, and then treating them.
Now presently, knowing the program or the intervention in the management of integrated management of acute malnutrition, this really convinced us, even my pediatrician, because really we need to establish one center to address this problem wherein we can really think of, we can really examine critically. Because when patients come into the hospital, we really do not have that kind of special milk formula or food to be given to our malnourished patient. And besides, the problem that is in community will be known to EBRMC, and there will be a feedback and a referral for us to improve the health of our children.
Already we have 16 sites that we're supporting, so our activities are in 16 health centers. Probably within the next 3 months we will open another 4 sites, so that the goal is that for any mother with a malnourished child, the distance for them to travel to a health center is as small as possible.